Okay, this is chapter one. I had to done another video just prior to this, but I thought maybe I'm gonna go too fast, so I'm just not gonna go so fast. I let out a huge sigh of relief and popped my head up to check if the coast is clear, which it is. My character Fred, he ends up going out, kind of crawling low on the ground as fast as he can, goes up to a tree, peeks around to the left, looks to the right, sees nobody's coming, hops over this little wooden fence thingy. It's like a homemade wooden fence that's been made out of like logs or sticks, kind of thick sticks. They're like, I don't know, about kind of like this big, or about this big, and they go straight across, and then up and down. Just everything's made out of wood. He hops that, he runs across the street, and goes to the RV, moves the siding open, goes in, closes it. What he does is to check to make sure the coast is clear, because he's in like high alert mode. Hold on, I have to. He goes into this mobile home right now, right here. He just walks out, he leaves the car. I might have him do something where he goes from here to his car, and actually he just crosses this fence, goes here, because he knows he's gonna have to leave his car there. If he takes his car, they're gonna catch him soon, and he doesn't know which way to go, so he's gotta keep his car there, because if it gets in his car, it's gonna take time to start it up. He's gonna drive. If he drives this way, they could be driving the opposite direction. And he doesn't know if they're going to catch him as he's pulling out. You know, if he comes out here, they could just pull right up. They could be driving right through here and catch him from this area. You can see here the car coming out. Or if they're coming from this direction, this intersection, they see him, they'll follow him. So he's got to be quick and smart. So he comes over here to this trailer. And I'm doing this on camera, that way it's faster, because it takes forever to write. So many ideas pop in my head. So I just decided I'm going to do this, and then write the details down on paper, or type it, which is faster. So he's like scared shitless. He goes across the street, and you know how they got the RV right here. Okay, let me get this crap out of the way. Yeah, there's siding. You know, boom, 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 boom. You guys know what I'm talking about. You move these to the side, you can put boxes underneath them. It's kind of hollow because it's kind of on stilts, like brick stilts or whatever. So he moves this out, but this is not long ways, it's short ways, so it's like, actually, you know what, yeah, so it's like this, but obviously it's like, actually way bigger, so, boom, 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 this is looking at the front. And there's like a window here. One of those three-sided windows, you know, that kind of like go out like this, like this, like this. So it goes in the siding of this area. And what he does is he moves. It's like a one, two, three, four, five, six, but screw that. Let me just erase this. He moves the siding to where he can look. There's three sidings in front of him. He takes the one in the middle. I just do it like this. This siding right here. And then siding right here. What he does is he moves this one a little bit back to where he can look out here and look out here. So what he does is he makes a view to where he can peek out the crack over here and over here. This dude is like scared shitless. These guys got silenced weapons. Like they'll shoot him and they don't give a fuck, you know. They'll kill him and then shoot him first and seek out the answers later. Or actually they won't kill him immediately, but they'll interrogate him. So then he ends up waiting for them. And then from that time that he's waiting, I don't know if I'm going to put something in the story that something happens and he's like what the hell kind of thing, like an animal or something. Maybe he hears a little growling. It's like a badger or something. But the black van comes down this road, pulls up, turns in this way, pulls in. The mafia guys are, you know, come out looking for him. They see his car, they come out, two guys come out, the other four guys, I don't know if it's going to be just two guys or all six guys. I mean, I can make it to where there's two guys in the driver's seat and up front, two guys up front, one in the driver, one in the passenger, and there's just like a body bag in the back. Or do I have four guys in the back? I don't know yet. But let's say for now there's six guys, so the two guys get out of the vehicle. And Fred is looking at them. They driver comes up to this side, looks in the window, they're both looking in, they don't see nothing. One of them stands out looking around, the other guy comes around here, and actually, you know what, there's a back door, it's a back porch, little steps too, and the back door. They look in. And I don't know if they break in or they just look in. I'm thinking, yeah, they break in. He breaks in, he searches the area. And I'm going to go into some detail about that too. Because I'm telling a deep story, so. And these aren't just ordinary bad guys, they're like top dog bad guys that know their stuff. So they go searching his room, they find his bag of equipment, and he goes, I'm thinking he maybe calls the other guy and says, yeah, I got a bag of, I got some equipment laying in this closet. Some of it's like stuff you're gonna need when you're going to break into someone's house. Excuse me. Hold on. Joseph Marino. No. Hold on. Not Joseph. Giovanni is outside. Marco Rodriguez. Marco is in here. Saying I found a... Actually... I don't know if that's going to be Marco. Because it's going to be the Italian Mafia and the Mexican Mafia. And they're like a big unit, you know. Something in just two Italian guys. So maybe Joseph Marino is in here. He searches the room, sees that Fred has some equipment in here. I gotta find out what the equipment is. I should write that list. And what they're gonna need to do, what they're gonna need to have to break into that one house. Because him and Chris are gonna end up breaking into this house, because this guy's, he's got some gold bars he's holding for a rich guy who owns like a big company. The guy's trying to keep it off the books, the gold he has, for some reason, I don't know, yet. I'm gonna shut this off and continue this on the next video. I gotta take care of something.